Welcome, my name is Deepakshi and I create DIY videos into fashion, jewelry, accessories and sometimes cartoon, and you are most welcome in this fresh episode of Art Knowledge, in which I am going to talk about 10 more new art documentaries which you should must watch to gain more knowledge about artworks and get to know more amazing artwork and artists around the world. So without wasting much time, let's just go and watch this video. The first documentary is Boom for Real, the late teenage years of Jen Miguel Basquiat. And in their teenage years, they don't know about them. Nobody knows how they spent their teenage years in the 1970s in New York. About that, this documentary is told. And if you also want to watch this documentary, you can watch it on Amazon Prime Video. It is 1 hour 18 minute long documentary released in year 2017 and directed by Sarah Trevor.
When people talk about Leonardo da Vinci, and when they talk about Jackson Pollock, they will also mention Jean-Michel Basquiat.
When I first met him, just a few months short of 16, he was living on the street, staying with God knows who.
The streets are so intimate. You could just sit on a bench and meet somebody. You could spend the whole day with you, you didn't even know who they were.
We came up with this thing, Samo. You know, this is the same old
Samo! S-A-M-O. Come on, you've seen it on the walls. This gentleman right here is Samo.
Samo was part of a conversation happening in New York.
The city was burning down, literally. The murder rate was at its highest point ever.
People were really angry at the establishment.
The eruption of graffiti inspired a lot of younger artists to take control over that situation on their own terms. What Basquiat understood was the nature of public space.
His work was a texture of the city around it.
He was discovering his own art form. The walls and floor were his canvas.
He was into letting art be itself, and that's why his work was very crude and childlike in some ways.
The first time I saw his graffiti, I said to him, you know, you're going to be as big as Andy Warhol.
At a certain point, John just took off, and you knew he was not coming back.
John knew that he only had a limited amount of time.
And I think that's what kept his wheels turning faster than everybody else.
What an example of a true investigator of visual ideas, language, and music.
Jean-Michel, with his work, had an effect on everybody that saw it.
So my second documentary is Tim Warmer. इस डॉक्यूमेंट्री में जो एक इन्वेंटर थे टिम जेनिसन, उन्होंने इन्वेंशन करी है और उन्होंने पता लगाने की कोशिश करी है कि जो फेमस 17th सेंचुरी के डच मास्टर आर्टिस्ट थे जॉनसन वर्मर, वो कैसे इतनी रियलिस्टिक पेंटिंग्स बनाते थे, क्या थ्योरी थी उनकी, क्या उनका आइडिया था. वो पूरी प्रोसेस उन्होंने इन्वेंट करने की और फाउंड आउट करने की कोशिश करी है इस पूरी डॉक्यूमेंट्री में. सो इफ़ यू ऑल्सो वॉन्ट टू know more about this documentary about this great artist, you can watch it on Amazon Prime Video. It was released in the year 2017 and directed by Taylor. Duration of this documentary is 1 hour 20 minutes.
Sometimes when I'm trying to get to sleep, all I can think about is trying to paint a Vermeer, who some consider the greatest painter of all time. At the face of it, that seems almost impossible, because I'm not a painter. I'm a computer graphics guy, and we use technology to make a realistic, beautiful image.
Tim and I have been friends for a really long time. I didn't know he had this whole little sub-obsession with Vermeer.
I'm looking at this image, and I see something that looks like it came out of a video camera. This fall off of light, something that an artist really cannot see. There must be a way to actually get the colors accurate with mechanical means. I propped up a small mirror at a 45-degree angle. Right on the forehead, you can see that they match.
Holy cow.
It took me about half an hour to learn how to operate a paintbrush.
Good for you, it took me 40 years.
It's possible that he was more of a tinkerer, more of a geek. And in that way, I feel a kinship with him.
So I'm going to construct a replica of the exact room where Vermeer painted.
That's right. The harpsichord, the Spanish chair, the viola da gamba, the rug. The wind's trying to blow my shape. Well, this certainly is not easy.
This is very ingenious.
That's where the painting is, Buckingham Palace. Using Tim's device, you've become a machine.
I'm proposing an alternate history of Vermeer.
Was Vermeer a machine?
Oh, my God.
I think it might disturb quite a lot of people.
If we weren't making a film, would I quit? Yeah, I definitely would. I'd find something else to do right now.
So my third documentary is Balzarelli, The Art of Forgery. This documentary made to famous Wolfgang Balzarelli है उनकी life और उनके work के बारे में बताया गया और कैसे बताया गया कि कैसे उन्होंने 40 साल तक international art world को forge किया है ये बताते हुए कि he's a great artist. उसके बारे में कोई documentary है उसके बारे में कोई story इस documentary में share की. If you also want to know more about this documentary, you can watch it on Amazon Prime Videos. It is released in year 2014, directed by Andy Biskstock, and the duration of this documentary is 1 hour 42 minutes.
Also, ich bin der Meinung, dass ich eigentlich alles malen könnte.
Vermeer könnte ich auch mal. Rembrandt
genauso.
Egal was.
Leonardo?
Natürlich. Gar nicht schwierig.
Gar nicht schwierig?
Finde ich nicht schwierig.
Eigentlich ist mein Vater schuld, dass ich Fälscher geworden bin. Für mich war Malen nichts Besonderes. Das hatte für mich nicht diese Heiligkeit.
Welchen Beruf er ausübt, das hat er mir nach 3 Tagen gesagt.
Ich habe so Gemälde gekauft, habe es dann auch restauriert. Und dann habe ich irgendwann gemerkt, dass die Händler sagten, ja, wenn da jetzt Figuren drauf wären, dann könnte man da viel, viel mehr Geld für bekommen. Wenn das so ist, habe ich mir überlegt, wieso malst du es dann nicht komplett neu? Ne?
Das ist schon eine beachtliche Leistung, wie nur ein Mann, kein großes Team, es geschafft hat, sämtliche Zentralen der internationalen Kunstwelt auszuschalten.
Ja, wir sind Opfer von einem super raffinierten Betrüger geworden.
So, jetzt haben wir wieder den Original Barcelona-Dreck von 1915.
Wir wissen ja bis heute nicht, wie viele Fälschungen er wirklich erschaffen hat.
Entstanden sind ungefähr 300.
Wir wussten natürlich, dass unser Vater Künstler ist. Hatten halt immer den Eindruck, dass er nicht viel arbeitet.
Ich hätte 2000 Bilder machen können und der Markt hätte es aufgenommen.
C'est quand même produit pour ce qu'on sait de quelques millions d'euros.
7.500.000 I have.
Ich wage zu behaupten, dass es einfacher ist, ein Bild zu verkaufen für 500.000 als eins für 10.000. Da glaubt einfach keiner mehr, dass das nicht echt ist.
Ich hätte mir so gern Palazzo in Venedig gekauft.
Na, dann habe ich den Palazzo in die Zelle getauscht.
Un peu avoir peut-être. Mais doué et sensible.
Wenn man in ein Museum kommt und sieht dann sein eigenes Bild da hängen, denkt man, ja verdammt, jetzt hängt es in allen möglichen Museen rum und keiner weiß, dass es von dir ist. Ne?
Was haben Sie da gedacht, wenn Sie das gelesen haben, dass da jemand sagt, das ist ein Campendong, wie er lebt und lebt und auch noch einer der schönsten?
Ja, hat er doch recht.
So my fourth documentary is Made You Look, a true story about fake art. इस documentary में जो अमेरिका में अब तक की सबसे बड़ी art forgery हुई है, art fraud हुआ है, उसके बारे में बताया गया है. इस documentary को direct किया है filmmaker Average Chronicles ने और इसको आप Netflix पर देख सकते हैं. ये year 2020 में release हुई.
Has the art world up in arms tonight.
The series of fakes that sold for tens of millions of dollars.
It takes more than a really talented con man to pull off a forgery of this magnitude.
She comes in off the street with supposed masterpieces in the trunk of her car.
An absolutely bizarre story for any dealer to accept.
These works went into the greatest museums in the world.
Either the paintings are all real or they're all fake.
We all know how that story turned out.
I was fooled. I believe the paintings were absolutely real.
How could you devise such a scheme?
My fifth documentary is Kazuma Infinity. This is about the artist Yayoi Kazuma. कैसे उन्होंने सेक्सिज्म और रेसिज्म से फाइट किया और अपना आर्टवर्क पूरे वर्ल्ड के सामने प्रेजेंट किया. हालांकि जबकि उनकी जो अपब्रिंगिंग थी वो जापान में एक बहुत कंजर्वेटिव फैमिली में हुई थी, इसके बाद भी उन्होंने जो टोक्यो के मेंटल इंस्टीट्यूशन है वहाँ पर अपने अपने आप अपना एक मुकाम बनाया. If you really want to know more about this amazing artist, you can watch this documentary on Amazon Prime Video. This was released in year 2018 और इसको डायरेक्ट किया है हेथर लेंस ने. इसकी ड्यूरेशन है 1 hour 20 minutes.
जो हम शुरू में या शुरू में जब उच्चारण करना मुझे समझ खांग गए थे इतना.
I'd never seen anything like it. They had some kind of magic.
そうそうってのは修正がないんですよ。パッとでしょ。初めてのことを突然のひらめきでパッとやって完璧なものですよ。
これ書いてあると、ね、北脇村奥でどんどんいくらでもアイデアが出てくるからもうね、カンバスが間に合わないくらいなんですよ。
Sometimes you can feel something like a tidal wave under your feet and you know that this artist is going to be big.
She was breaking all boundaries of space. No longer are you the viewer the master. She's the master of infinity.
She was not taken seriously by the establishment. Not only was she a woman, she was also Japanese.
Kusama was creating work of equal importance, yet she wasn't getting the same backing.
It was a very difficult time for her.
I became so depressed one day. So the窓からね、下へ飛び降りたね。
Her mother had outrageous disrespect for Kusama's interest in art.
At some point she would have to escape.
Dear Miss O'Keefe, I'm only on the first step of a long, difficult life of being a painter. Will you kindly show me the way?
O'Keefe gave her advice to come to the United States to bring her work with her.
So that 私の病気をね、アートにね、転化させる。
She was suffering from rejection of that art world.
And she finds this hospital interested in art therapy. And she checks herself in.
Kusama was recognized for the 1993 Venice Biennial Pavilion.
She's celebrated all over the world. Her work transcends boundaries, and there's not one artist in the world who has that same audience.
Our documentary is Maple Throp, Look at the Pictures. ये documentary America के famous artists के बारे में है जिनके बारे में बहुत controversies हुई थी year 1989 में जब उनकी AIDS के वजह से death हुई थी. Artist का नाम है Robert Mapplethorpe. उनकी life से जुड़ी पूरी history और उनकी पूरी story इस art documentary में share की गई है. So if you also want to know about this amazing artist, you can watch this documentary on Netflix. And this is directed by Randy Barbato and Fanto Bates. This was released in year 2016 and the duration of this documentary is 1 hour 48 minutes.
Robert Mapplethorpe, who spent the last years of his life promoting homosexuality. Now, any senator who thinks that I'm attacking aesthetic art, if they have any doubt, and look at the pictures, look at the pictures, look at the pictures.
He loved to get a jolt out of people, a reaction. It was power. Just the way he dressed, the way he carried himself, the artist encompassed him.
I always was fascinated with the idea of taking sexuality and bringing it to a level that it hadn't been to before.
There was tension. My father wouldn't look at Robert.
He was really not part of the family.
He was so busy being Robert Mapplethorpe to really care.
Everything was a means to an end to his career.
He was a new type of art.
The whole point of being an artist is to learn about yourself. The photographs, I think, are less important than the life that one is leading.
So next documentary is Bansky Dolls New York. इस डॉक्यूमेंट्री में जो फिल्म मेकर यानी कि डायरेक्टर है क्रिस मॉकेबल, वो 30 डेज यानी कि एक महीने के लिए न्यूयॉर्क सिटी में रहे थे और उन्होंने एक्सपीरियंस किया और अपना एक्सपीरियंस पूरा शेयर किया इस डॉक्यूमेंट्री में कि क्या बैंस्की का आइडिया था, थॉट प्रोसेस थी, कैसे उन्होंने अपने आइडियाज को जो उस शहर के हैं न्यूयॉर्क के उसको पिक्चर्स में कन्वर्ट किया और एक फेमस स्ट्रीट आर्टिस्ट. So if you also want to know more about this amazing artist and history and story behind this artist, you can watch this documentary on Netflix, which was released in year 2014. directed by Chris Walkable, and the duration of this documentary is 1 hour 19 minutes.
There's a well-known graffiti artist who's making his mark in New York City, on New York City.
Banksy.
I've heard about this guy for years.
He's like the most famous artist on earth.
He's anonymous in the age where it's nearly impossible to be anonymous.
Banksy has promised to create a new work of art every day this month in New York.
With Banksy, you never know what happens tomorrow.
It's stopping people dead in their tracks.
Banksy managed to create this huge installation on the Lower East Side without anyone seeing him.
The audience participation was a part of the show.
This is public art, public space for anyone to experience and to enjoy together.
It's like performance art. It's like epic street theater.
It was like a happening, just this momentary thing, and either you were there or you missed it.
It was driving a Banksy around the city and hordes of people following it. Gotta get in, get my picture.
The response to it would be part of the art itself.
Not everyone is happy with Banksy tonight.
NYPD is hot on his trail.
The NYPD is calling to arrest the artist.
Police are still trying to track this guy down.
You running up to public property and defacing it is not my definition of art.
The twist of Banksy is that when he vandalizes your property, its value goes up.
You try to get some bread. This is my way.
So you want us to me to take a picture?
Yes.
So people are taking Banksy's work.
Guys, step back.
They're cutting them out of the wall, and they're selling them without authorization.
This is the Banksy portion of the auction.
There's been a rash of greed surrounding the concrete sphinx he put up on Tuesday near City Field.
You don't understand the social currency involved in this. Please put it back up.
Do you really want to own a Banksy that badly?
How this place created what we New Yorkers love. A fight on the streets.
So the next documentary is The Price of Everything. This documentary में बताया गया है कि जो हमारा consumerist culture है और जो contemporary art world है उसकी ज़रूरत हमारी day-to-day life को कैसे है और कैसे हम उस culture को use कर सकते हैं हमारी life improve करने के लिए, कैसे हमारी जो आसपास की society है, surroundings है, उसको हम better बना सकते हैं इस culture के through contemporary art के. So if you also want to know more about this documentary, you can watch it on HBO Documentaries. This duration of this documentary was 1 hour 45 minutes, released in 2018 and directed by Nathleen Kerr.
The auction will begin shortly. Please take your seats.
Art and money have always gone hand in hand. It's very important for good art to be expensive.
$16 million, $17 million.
You only protect things that are valuable. If something has no financial value, people don't care.
People are very seduced and it just becomes about the money.
Bubbles make beautiful things. Keep it floating. Don't burst it.
What is it that makes a piece of art worth $10 million, $20 million?
Great things tell you they're great.
It moved me so much.
There are no rules about what is going to be good and what is going to be bad.
Because art is art.
What's more important, art or life? I would say art, because at least it lives forever.
Never made any money until recently.
They tried to make it like the best artist is the most expensive artist. How could it be true?
The art world is a very brutal place.
Is it absurd? Yes.
At $30 million. Sorty, thank you very much indeed.
There's a lot of people that know the price of everything and the value of nothing.
Thank you. the next documentary is Struggle, the Life and the Lost Art of Sosowski. Is documentary made jo famous Polish painter or sculptor artist hai Stanley Sosowski, unki jo never seen footage hai aur interviews hai jo kabhi publish nahi hue unke bare mein bataya gaya hai, unki life ke bare mein bataya gaya hai. If you also want to know about this amazing painter, you can know it on, you can watch this documentary on Netflix. It was available on Netflix since 2018, and it was released in 2018. The duration of this documentary is 2 hours and directed by Andrzej Dabrowski.
To me, Shukalski is kind of a mystic, a modern master.
He was creating art that was inspired by another dimension.
I thought he was dead,
and he lives like 5 miles away from me.
Mr. Bill Collector, come in, I have something very important to tell you.
You could just tell this guy was pent up to tell his story.
I was born in Poland. This was very long ago.
This is like reaching back through time.
This is one of my sculptures.
They were just absolutely fantastic.
What's going on in this guy's head must be vast.
I had to have some bush.
He was almost like a punk or something.
Art critics are parasites.
He threw the guy down a flight of stairs.
I'm not sure he thought people were lesser.
This is really strong arm.
But I know he thought he was the greatest.
Genius. I'm the greatest in human history.
I thought he was amazing. Why is this guy left behind?
I have died in Los Angeles, the cultural Siberia of America. I'm alone. I'm a patriot.
Tragedies that took place in Europe just pulse through the entire body of work.
Hundreds of projects, all these were destroyed.
Losing his life's work, I don't know how he didn't have a mental breakdown. We had no way of knowing what these things connected to in his past. We were all blindsided.
If you want to create new things for this world,
culmination of all his rage and his madness.
Never listen to anybody. Shukalski was Michelangelo of the 20th century.
We need to rewrite the history books.
Unbelievable.
So the 10th and the last documentary of this episode, which I'm going to suggest to you, is Marina Abramovic, The Artist's Prison. Is documentary mein jo great artist hai Marina Abramovic, unki life se judi aur unki jo emotional exhibitions thi, unse judi jo unseen clips thi, wo share ki gayi hain. Aur bataya gaya hai ki kya unki thought process thi, kya unki inspirations thi, us art exhibition ko publish karne ki, us present karne ki. और क्या उनको प्रमोट किया, उनके जो अनऑर्थोडॉक्स मेथड्स थे उनको इस डॉक्यूमेंट्री में प्रमोट किया गया है, बताया गया है उनके बारे में. सो इफ यू आल्सो वांट टू नो अबाउट दोज मेथड्स एंड दिस अमेजिंग आर्टिस्ट, यू कैन वॉच इट ऑन IMDb. इट वाज रिलीज्ड इन ईयर 2012, डायरेक्टेड बाय मैथ्यू एक्वर्स, एंड द ड्यूरेशन ऑफ दिस डॉक्यूमेंट्री इज 1 hour 46 minutes.
Performance is all about state of mind. The hardest thing is to do something which is close to nothing, because it's demanding all of you.
She is directly and boldly challenging an audience.
Art is must be beautiful.
She needs the audience like air to breathe.
There is only one question I didn't hear since 10 years. Why is this art?
She slows everybody's brain down. She transforms us as a result.
Destroying MoMA is important. I want to be a real form of art before I die.
Marina Abramovic, the artist is present, means she will be present.
Marina, are you nervous about the show at the MoMA?
Incredibly.
And when you're sitting in the chair, what are you looking at?
Anybody who's sitting in front of me, it's just the gaze.
7.5 hours, 6 days a week, motionless.
It's a matter of time before firing someone in the face is going to be hard.
This is about limit, even for me.
So with this, the amazing episode of Must Watch Art Documentary comes to an end. If you want to know more about art documentary, then do watch my episode 3 for more art documentary suggestions. Till then, keep watching my art channel, Creative Karkhana. Do subscribe and share with your loved ones. We'll see you next time. Till then, tata bye. See you.